is this world? What have they done to us? What did they do to us?
Hawaii's it, and they're all buying there. And they're all building bunkers, and nobody's talking about it. That, to me, says end of days is on its way. Something's about to happen where they're going to just go there and bunker in, close the doors with their close relatives and friends and family. 30 people is enough.
You know what? This reminds me so much of the movie. You still haven't seen it, with that Barack Obama was a producer on, and I think he helped write some of the material.
Really?
You know, we talked about it on the show previously.
Barack Obama, though. I didn't hear you talking about Obama.
Yeah, it's Barack Obama and Michelle Obama were producers on this
Michael.
Movie.
Michael Obama. The man.
Sorry,
the
I don't man, know why I didn't catch on straight away. I'm like, who the fuck's Michael Obama? Yeah, but they were producers on it. And it's
I did not fucking know.
I'm sure we brought that
you
up.
You told me about it was Julia Roberts, yeah?
Yeah, Julia Roberts.
Is that
Roberts.
That movie you've been going on about? Yeah, but you've never mentioned that Obama was a director?
Yeah, no, not a director, a producer. So he's the one who put the money up, and he was a consultant on it. Yeah, you didn't know that. I'm 100% sure I brought it up on the show. Hey. You were probably just zoning off.
Hey, no, I just don't remember hearing that Obama was part of it.
Leave the World Behind. It was.
Yeah. Right. Well, holy fucking smokes.
Oh, yeah, and, you got it right. Leave the World Behind. So, listen, you've got to watch it because you will totally freak out, because it's got all of this shit in it, and there's an underground bunker in it as well, where one of the kids that's in the show finds this bunker and turns it all on, and it's basically Mark Zuckerberg's blueprint. It's also got Tesla cars going berserk and going in one spot and just smashing into each other.
I was just going to say, it all sounds exactly the same as what's going on. And, you know, they say, I guess, that they've got to talk about it. But, I mean, the thing is, for the longest time, whenever you hear about something happening, it seems like somehow this is connected, but who knows how come. There's like all these breadcrumbs, but the breadcrumbs are now getting that thick that they're starting to become loaves of bread. The 15-minute cities, that all makes sense. If you were to really declare a war on the world of free people, you would want them locked into 15-minute cities. You don't want them moving around. You want to know where everyone is. And 15 minutes or 10 minutes or however big your area is, that's how big you want it to be. You're going to have, people guarding those entrances, and then you're going to want people to fill out, paperwork, or, as was brought up before, no one does paper anymore. Obviously, it'll be digital, but it's still called paperwork. Fill out paperwork and things to be able to visit someone or leave, and you'd be permitted X amount, and you would have, in that case, of course, electric vehicles are going to be better than petrol vehicles. In a 15-minute city, you don't even need a car, but if you do have one, you can just charge it because you're only driving 15 minutes in any direction. That would last you weeks.
Hey, Anne just said that they're so fucking brazen now, they'll tell you what's coming. So I was thinking, there's a 2-minute clip I just found on YouTube. Might just play that, and then maybe we'll wrap it up, eh?
Yeah, mate. Sounds good to me.
Dad, the TV isn't working.
Oh, easy, baby. Come on.
Dad, can you fix it?
Well, now it's snow. Last night it was a blue screen. wonder what that means.
What?
Yeah, see, no, it's not working.
I'm aware. Can you like reboot it or something? Or go up on the roof or whatever?
No one's going on the roof.
I am definitely not going up on the roof, okay? But I'm gonna go to the store later and maybe I can find something that, you know, help. You know, get one of those, some rabbit ears or something.
Why would a rabbit's ear help?
Oh, so it's an actual clip. I thought it was going to be a trailer.
Is this the movie?
Yeah, this is the actual movie. Yeah. This is sort of a bit off.
That's right.
There is animals trying to warn them. Or just animals are just doing strange behavior in the movie.
Was this on Netflix, this movie you're talking about?
Yeah.
I thought it was an older movie. It's not.
Nah. Okay. It's just come out. Ethan Hawke as well. He's, I love him.
I saw that. I saw Ethan.
Yeah. Kevin Bacon's got a cameo in it as well.
He's got a NASA shirt on.
Yeah, that as well. Yeah.
Well, that looks cool, man.
I knew something was coming.
Ongoing cyber attack. Yeah, this is happening.
What is the truth? There is no going back to normal.
It's not a feel-good movie, obviously, but I reckon it's a definite recommend for you to watch, Wayne, and for anyone else who's interested, because I just keep going, this is exactly what we're talking about all the time, and, you know, Schwab is warning us with a cyber attack, and then you've got a movie coming out with Barack Obama giving notes to the director and executive producing it.